Welcome back to another video. In this one today, we're going to be continuing the series through the book of Ephesians. We're going to be beginning in Ephesians chapter 3, verses 1 through 3. The scripture says, "For this reason, I, Paul, a prisoner of Christ Jesus, on behalf of you Gentiles, assuming that you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for you, how the mystery was made known to me by revelation, as I have written briefly." So we see here in verse 1 that Paul was a prisoner on behalf of the Gentiles, a prisoner of Christ Jesus. So he was in prison for his faith and for boldly declaring the gospel. This is what he was imprisoned throughout his ministry. If you look at the book of Acts, the letter of Philippians, for example, is another one where he was imprisoned while he was writing that letter. The letter of Philemon is another. So he was definitely persecuted for his faith on several different occasions, and he suffered for proclaiming the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, but he maintained faithfulness and joy in Christ, even in those imprisonments, and used those imprisonments to proclaim the gospel. For example, the Philippian jailer who was converted during his imprisonment there in Philippi at one point, and other instances as well. But we see here in verse 2 where he talks about the stewardship of God's grace that was given to him, given to me for you. So God's grace wasn't just given to Paul so that Paul could keep it. It was given to Paul so that Paul could proclaim it, right? So he was saved by the work of the Lord Jesus Christ, but he wasn't saved just to go sit in a room by himself somewhere. No, he was saved, and as a fruit of that, he goes out and he boldly proclaims the gospel to Jew and to Gentile. We know obviously the bulk of Paul's ministry was focused to the Gentiles, especially. And in verse 3, we see where he talks about the mystery, which is we'll discuss later on in verse 6 of this chapter. The mystery is the fact that the Jews and Gentiles are both able to come into one body, the church, through the Lord Jesus Christ. And he talks about how this mystery was made known to him by revelation. It was God himself that showed Paul the gospel. Jesus Christ himself appeared to Paul. And this was not told to him by some hearsay or something of that sort. It was told directly by God, directly by revelation. And this apostle faithfully proclaimed the gospel throughout his ministry. I hope you are blessed by the video today, and we'll see you in the next one. Have a great day.